Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon.
This is the Yukon, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston. A melting pot of people from all over the world who came in the quest for sudden riches. The Pork Trail, the main artery of transportation between Whitehorse and Dawson after the winter freeze-up. Basil Ogden, an escaped convict from the States, had left behind him a series of vicious assaults and robberies as he moved south from Dawson.
It's Ogden's trademark, King. We're headed for McQueston. He's not far ahead of us, either.
Led by his great dog, Yukon King, Sergeant Preston took up pursuit of the criminal down the Pork Trail.
I left sunny California in a comfortable cell for this. Better be worth it. That's all I got to say. Oh, must be a cabin nearby. Well, here's where Basil Ogden gets thawed out.
Hello there.
Hi. I'm cold and dog tired. You mind if I stop in and thaw out for a minute?
Oh, glad to have someone to talk to. Take off your snowshoes and come in.
Thanks.
Stranger here, aren't you? We don't see many snowshoes like those around here. Where are you bound for?
South on the trail. Heard you chopping as I was going by.
Make those snowshoes yourself?
No, bought them off of an Indian. Hey, you sure ask a lot of questions, mister.
Sorry. Habit, I guess. Come on, let's go in.
On second thought, I better be getting on. Thanks anyway.
Nonsense, man. Hot cup of tea will do you good.
Constable Harry Atkins knew there was something familiar about his guest, especially the odd snowshoes. He decided to delay Ogden until he could satisfy himself.
How are things in Dawson?
I don't know. I'm from Lost Chance.
Oh, my mistake. Oh, you said you were heading south. Guess I just took it for granted you came from Dawson. Ever have to run into my friend, Sergeant Preston?
No. You mentioned something about some tea.
Oh, yeah, sure thing. Sorry. I didn't mean to be such a poor host. I thought you might have met Preston on the trail. He's one of the best men on the force. Truth is, I was expecting him when you came along. I got word he's looking for a fellow named Basil Ogden. I'm Constable Harry Atkins. You mind telling me who you are?
Sweetheart! Snow shoes, your telegraph description, huh?
You'll never live to prove it!
Give up, Ogden. You haven't got a chance.
Up to nobody. The stakes too big.
Hey, Atkins, you in there? Atkins?
He got away. Shot me with my own gun. Sergeant, he's heading south. Get him. Don't worry about me. I'll be all right.
Oh, our gun will keep. He won't get far. Before I leave, I'll have to dress that wound.
What can I do for you, stranger?
First thing you can do is fetch me some grub.
Sure thing. How'll you have it? In or out of harness?
Speak English, will you? I'm in no mood for jokes.
I can see that by the looks of that eye of yours. What I asked was whether you wanted that grub in or out of the tin. You eating it here or taking it with you?
I'm eating here.
Then just make yourself comfortable at one of those tables, stranger. Come again, fellers. I guess this just ain't the right night for conversation.
Hey. You're pretty well acquainted here, boss?
Sure am. Know 'em all. You looking for somebody?
Yeah. Friend of mine and his wife, I heard, live near here. Thought I might pay him a call. Name's Godfrey. Was a doc in the States. You know him?
You got me there, stranger. The only doctor in this district is old Doc Furman, but he's never been hitched. Though every widow from Dawson to Whitehorse has set her cap for him. Guess old Doc knows when he's well off.
There's a picture of him. Does that help your memory any? Never mind, I'll hold it.
Why, that's Jim and Nan Graham. Come here last summer. Oh, nice folks. But Jim never said anything about being a medical man. What name did you call him?
Never mind. Where do they live?
Well, they took over Whitey Dodger's old place in Scarface Flats.
Where's Scarface Flats?
East of here. On No Gold Creek at the foot of Lake Ethel.
I'll need some supplies and a pair of snowshoes. Can you fix me up?
Sure, stranger. But you ain't fixing to light out now, are you?
You know, you missed your trade. You should have been a lawyer, all the questions you ask. Now, will you fetch that stuff?
Sure, sure.
Here you are. Drink this if you feel up to it. Make you feel better.
Thanks a lot, Sergeant. You know, I sure feel guilty letting that Ogden fellow slip through my fingers. Acted like a green rookie.
There's nothing wrong with your procedure. You're not expected to make an arrest on mere suspicion, even though your suspicions happen to be correct.
Now, you say that Ogden killed a guard and broke out of San Quentin prison, right?
That's right. He's a cunning and dangerous criminal. Human life means nothing to him.
It's unbelievable.
The story behind the break and Ogden's subsequent career is even more unbelievable. A San Francisco bookkeeper by the name of Dominic Moretti was sentenced to prison for embezzlement. And as the story goes, Moretti secretly buried the loot.
Where does Basil Ogden fit in?
Ogden was Moretti's cellmate. He'd learned about the looting. But before he could worm any information from Moretti, Moretti broke jail with the help of his daughter and her husband, who figured him innocent.
Oh, so Ogden made his own escape in order to follow them.
Exactly. He planned to obtain the stolen cash by means of blackmail, but it was too late. Moretti died of a heart attack in a Los Angeles hideout, and the Godfreys disappeared.
Well, if that's correct, then the Godfreys must be somewhere in the Yukon now.
Possibly. Actually, Ogden is the only one that's on our wanted list so far. If we should identify the Godfreys by chance, well, it'd be our duty to wire the information to the California police.
Do we have a bulletin on them?
No, nothing specific, except that Godfrey's an exceptionally fine surgeon, and there are no registered surgeons of his ability in the Yukon.
Well, is there a chance that the Godfreys have the loot with them?
There's always that possibility.
John, why do you torture yourself?
The two of us worked hard to earn what's in this box, Feta.
I know. Now it's useless. It's my fault. It never would have happened if I hadn't persuaded you to help Father break out of prison.
I've no regrets over that, Feta. He was an innocent man.
What are you planning to do with that, John?
Well, valuable as it is, it's the only link connecting us to Dr. and Mrs. John Godfrey. I'm getting rid of it.
No, you can't, John. There's nothing else left but that. And no one will find us here. In a few years, people will forget. We can start over again.
All right. I'll put it back where we've had it hidden for the time being. Veta, I didn't mention this before because I didn't want to alarm you. Ogden's been seen in Dawson.
I don't believe it. How can you be sure?
Well, Constable Atkins told me about a dangerous criminal in this area on my last trip into town. His description fitted Ogden.
Oh, no. Please, heaven, no. Will he never leave us alone?
Not until he gets his blood money.
He's mad, insane.
Tomorrow, I'll drive the sled into McQuesten and do some checking. If there's been nothing further on Ogden, well, we'll stay here. But if Atkins was right, we'll have to make some new plans.
Don't leave me alone, please, John.
Just for a little while. I'll take the shortcut through Grizzly Pass to save time. And now, as your doctor, I prescribe sleep and lots of it.
Next morning, assured that Atkins was well enough to take care of himself, Preston followed Ogden's trail as far as McQuesten.
Yep, he's your man all right, Sergeant. And he's wearing a new pair of snowshoes, just like these. I sold them to him. Cash.
Well, if Ogden's headed for Scarface Flats, he'll not be hard to trail this time of the year. No one lives there but the Grahams. You say Graham was in here this morning?
That's right. And when I told him about this Ogden feller, he turned white as a ghost and skedaddled without so much as a by your leave.
It's true the Grahams have no visible means of support, but I'd never judge them to be criminals.
I still can't believe it, Sergeant. They're nice people. Very refined they are.
Well, I'll send a wire back to Dawson for a tracer on them. Thanks, Al. Come on, King.
John, I didn't expect you back so soon.
Kind of surprised to see me, hey, Mrs. Godfrey? Been a long time, hasn't it? Since you sneaked away from me in Los Angeles. You and that husband of yours. You remember, don't you? The night the old man had the heart attack? By the way, where is your husband, Mrs. Godfrey?
He's gone to McQuesten.
You're lying. I didn't pass him on the trail. But no matter, you know what I'm here for and you know where it is. Now hand it over.
My father was innocent. There was never any stolen money.
You sneaking little devil, there's a fortune in cash. Now where is it?
No, no, there's nothing.
Who's that?
Hot boy, go.
You know who it is, huh? Get me the cash or I'll kill him. All right, you had your chance.
John, look out!
Who? Stop right where you are, Doc. Throw that gun outside. Throw it outside, I said, or so help me, I'll shoot her. That's better. Now march in here. Shut that door. Get your hands up high. Now maybe you'll be a little more sensible than this wildcat of yours.
While Dawson checked on the Grahams with state's authorities, Preston headed for Scarface Flats with King, where...
That's it. What's left of it.
Dump it out on the table and no tricks.
That's it. Open it.
What are you two trying to give me? A few lousy $100?
That's it, Ogden. The last of our life savings. Almost $1,000. Now take it and leave us alone. We're tired of running.
You're breaking my heart.
It's the truth.
Look, Ogden, if there'd been any Moretti loot, wouldn't some of it have been used to finance his legal defense after he was accused of stealing from his employers? Now use your head.
Just what I'm doing, Doc, and that's why I think you're lying. You didn't find the money till after Moretti broke jail. He told you where it was hidden. Then you left him to die while you two stole it.
What you're accusing us of is monstrous.
But you liked the box the money was hidden in so well, you carried it all the way to the Yukon empty. I know you have a little metal box. Where is it? The fun's over. I've killed two men already getting here. Two more murders won't matter. Now one of you talk and talk fast.
Very well. I'll show you where it's hidden.
You. Nothing to keep me from killing you now, and I...
On you, Hunky! Hunky! Reach!
Looks of this, King. Just a minute, I'll unhitch you and you can guard the rear.
There's a Mountie coming. Get rid of him. I'll be behind this door with this gun on your wife, so don't try to get smart.
Sergeant Preston.
This your gun, Graham?
Right. Yes, it is. Thanks for bringing it in.
Very careless leaving it outside in the snow, aren't you?
I forgot it.
Forgot to unhitch your team, too. Anything wrong, Graham?
No, nothing's wrong. Nothing at all.
Where's Mrs. Graham?
Well, I don't know. I just got here.
That's too bad. I was hoping to find the two of you in. There are a few questions I'd like to ask the both of you.
Maybe some other time.
No, you can tell me what I want to know right now. What do you know about a man named Basil Ogden?
Basil Ogden? Is there any reason I should know him?
Yes. Al Myers said he asked for you last night. And I tracked him here to this cabin.
But why should he come here? He's certainly no friend of ours.
I didn't ask you that. Ask if you knew him.
I knew a lot of people in the United States.
Your entry papers give your hometown to Santa Rosa, California. You ever lived in San Francisco?
Well, that's not far from Santa Rosa, Sergeant. I've been there on business.
What business, Graham?
But before I answer any more questions, I'd like to know what this is all about.
If you're going to prefer some kind of charges against me, I have the right to consult an attorney.
These are just routine questions, Graham. I'm here principally to find a murder. Basil Ogden.
I hope you find him, Sergeant. Ogden sounds dangerous.
He is. The dangerous and treacherous criminal. Anyone that trusts him is just asking to be killed. He never leaves any witnesses alive.
Go, you huskies!
Johnny's getting away.
Well, that's not important now.
And he's hurt King.
Well, help me with the sergeant, then we'll tend to King.
What are you going to do?
What any doctor would do. Well, here it is. The bullet should be removed to lessen the chances of septic poison.
If you operate, you'll disclose our identities. You'll be saving the man who'll send us to prison.
I'm still a doctor. Heat some water, please.
Yes, John.
Within a few hours after his first hasty flight into the hills, Ogden backtrailed and discovered he was not being followed. Perhaps he had killed Preston, he thought. Cannily, he doubled back to a high spot where he could look down on the Godfrey cabin unseen under cover of darkness.
You're fine now, aren't you, King?
Fortunately, the bullet entered the fleshy part of your shoulder. But you won't be able to use this arm for a few days.
I'll be careful of it, Doctor.
Sergeant, now that you know who we are, I suppose that you'll have to take us in.
My first job is to catch Ogden. He's probably back in those hills by now. As soon as day breaks, King and I...
Oh, goodness, in all the excitement, you forgot to feed your dogs. Listen to those wolves.
My team is still there. Those aren't wolves, they're hungry huskies.
You're right, that's my team. I'd recognize that whining cry anywhere. That's Jenny, my lead dog.
You're right, John.
It means Ogden probably doubled back when he found out he wasn't being followed. He could be watching this cabin right now.
But why?
He may think he killed me, when he's sure in his own mind he'll be back after that money. Because I don't think he's afraid of either of you.
You're going after him?
No, I've a better plan. I'm sure we can make Mr. Ogden come to us. Doctor, would you get the rifle and tarp out of my sled?
Right.
Now, let's go over this once more so that we'll all know what we're doing.
Well, you want us to stuff the tarp with blankets so that it looks like a body and then dump it outside in a snowdrift.
Right. Then come back in the cabin and we'll wait for Mr. Ogden to show up. Meanwhile, King and I'll conceal ourselves in the other room.
Now, you think that Ogden will take the bait?
Oh, I'm sure he will. You'll think that he killed me and that you don't want a dead body in the cabin and you're temporarily disposing of it.
How soon do you want us to do this?
As soon as it's daylight. I want to be sure Ogden sees everything. Far so good. We'll know shortly if our plan will work. Come on, King, we'll wait in the other room.
Can you see him? Is he coming?
No, not yet.
What if the sergeant is wrong? What if Ogden doesn't come?
Well, nothing will be lost except some time. I'm sure Preston knows what he's doing.
I can't stand this any longer. I can't.
Beth, please, dear. It's taken me 2 years.
She's not going to kill us.
Get me that box now. It's the end of the road for you, Godfrey.
You mean the end of the road for you, Ogden? Drop that gun.
So I didn't get you, Mounty. But it's no good. Even if you get me, I'll make sure that one of the Godfreys goes with you.
Back, King. On your feet, Ogden.
Doctor, put these handcuffs on him.
Your hands behind you.
You're not going to let them keep the loot, are you?
Mrs. Godfrey, show Mr. Ogden what he's been chasing and killing for all these years.
There's no money in the box. Nothing but surgical instruments.
That's right. The doctor's been using that box to hide his instruments in. If Moretti hid any stolen funds, these people never found it. I believe they're telling the truth. I arrest you in the name of the Crown. Now turn around and face the vault.
Did you get your message, Sergeant?
Yes, I picked it up on the way through town. I'll read it aloud. It's addressed to me from headquarters. Information, Sacramento. Another criminal has confessed crime of which Moretti was convicted. Governor offers clemency to Godfrey and wife as partial restitution. Congratulations, Inspector Dew. Take your prisoner, Constable.
All right, Ogden, let's go.
Well, you know what this means.
We're free.
John.
Well, King, the doctor can take all the cases he wants. Except this one. This case is closed.